Here are some of the most expensive private islands owned by the richest people. Number 9, Musha Cay. In 2006, magician David Copperfield bought 4 different islands in the Bahamas. He actually only uses the roughly 100-acre Musha Cay as a private resort for rent. The other 3 islands he bought just to make sure he'd have total privacy for his guests. He paid a total of $50 million for this type of exclusivity. But spending $50 million for the islands wasn't enough. He then dropped another $40 million to renovate the properties on the island to turn it into an awe-inspiring, all-inclusive travel destination. The island's tagline? Discover paradise. But he wasn't done. He also bought 6 more islands nearby, completing an archipelago of 11 islands, now known as the Islands of Copperfield Bay. With over 700 acres of tropical land, Copperfield's resort is an adult's paradise. He wanted the island to be the, quote, most magical vacation destination in the world. For example, there's an option for fireworks that cost $25,000. Amazingly, roughly 60% of the groups that book the island order them. There's also a 3-hour treasure hunt with a pirate theme that costs $20,000, but 60% of the guests go for this as well. The entire island is only rented out to one person at a time. The only other guests are whoever that person invites. Each night on the island costs $57,000 for the full experience of 24 guests staying in the 5 different houses on the island. And yes, there is a minimum stay on the island, which is 4 nights. Just in case you're wondering who stayed on the island, the list includes Bill Gates, Oprah, and Johnny Depp. Number 8, Lanai. Larry Ellison, the co-founder of Oracle, bought the most expensive island for somewhere between a whopping $300 million. Technically, he owns 98% of the island, with the rest owned by the state of Hawaii. However, although this island is secluded, it's not that private. Ellison bought the island not to use only for himself. He had planned to use it as an experimental model for environmentally friendly practices. For example, he's built 2 20,000 square foot hydroponic greenhouses on the island, called Sensei Farms, that are powered by Tesla solar panels. Lanai is the smallest inhabited island in Hawaii, and it was once known as the Pineapple Island because of its origins as a pineapple plantation. Today, there's one small town, Lanai City, where there's not even a traffic light. The 140 square mile island is home to roughly 32,000 people. There are local businesses to support the people that live on the island, as well as 2 golf courses, a police station, and a school. There are 3 hotels on the island, and that includes 2 Four Seasons resorts. Ellison owns the hotels, the water company, the cemetery, the supermarket, and nearly a third of all the housing on the island. He's in negotiations to buy the island's electric grid. He spent a little more than $41 million putting in additional homes on the island. His vision for his laboratory for sustainability would complete with a solar power system, electric car infrastructure, and a seawater irrigation system for organic farms. Number 7, Scorpios. This famous private Greek island was once owned by shipping giant Aristotle Onassis, and it was bought by Russian billionaire heiress Ekaterina Rybakova for roughly $153 million in 2013. Her dad, Dmitry, is worth around $6.7 billion by Forbes' latest estimate, making him the 224th richest person in the world in 2021. This is to say, her dad can easily afford it. Scorpios is a 74-acre island that's off the west coast of mainland Greece in the Ionian Sea. Aristotle Onassis purchased the island for less than $20,000 in 1963, but that was before he put in the utilities, imported sand, and planted forests. He built a family compound that includes 3 houses and also a helicopter pad. He married former First Lady Jacqueline Kennedy on the island in 1968. That brought a lot of attention to Greece as a vacation destination. Apparently, Rybakova bought Scorpios and Sparty for business as well as pleasure. She supposedly still has plans to create an island retreat for the world's richest and most powerful people. A new complex of luxurious villas, as well as a brand new marina, were some of her plans for the island. However, Scorpios has been designated as environmentally protected by the Greece government. This means that no more than 5% of the island can be developed. Number 6. Necker Island. Richard Branson's Necker Island is easily one of the most famous private islands out there. Necker Island is 74 acres and it's part of the British Virgin Islands. Before he was actually rich, Branson bought the island in 1978 for only $180,000. Necker Island has been uninhabited before Branson bought it. He bought Necker Island when he was just 28, 6 years after starting Virgin Group. The story behind the sale shows how Branson approached life. At that time, he and his partners were still in the early days of Virgin Records. Branson by no means had the money to buy an island that was advertised for $6 million. But he was trying to impress a girl he liked, so he called up the realtor to say he was interested. The realtor flew him on an all-expenses-paid trip to see the islands. Branson agreed to go on one condition, only if he could bring a guest. So he and his date were given a luxury villa and they were flown around British Virgin Islands by helicopter. The final island he saw was Necker Island, and he fell in love with the island. There was no way he couldn't purchase Necker. However, there was that little problem of Branson not having money to buy the island. But he figured that he had nothing to lose. So he made the lowball offer of $100,000. The owner was so insulted, Branson actually had to figure out a way off the island himself. But the owner eventually got over it. After a year, nobody had made an offer on Necker Island. By that time, the owner was desperate to sell because he needed cash. So Branson quickly agreed to a purchase price of only $180,000. The only condition was that Branson would build a resort on the island within 4 years. Today, Branson rents out the island for around $60,000 a day. The complex can house up to 34 guests, and of course, there are facilities for luxury yachts. But not everything has been smooth for the island. For example, in 2011, the Great House burned down while actress Kate Winslet was staying on the island. Then, in 2017, most of Necker Island was destroyed by Hurricane Irma. Number 5. Bonds Cay. In 2011, Shakira and Pink Floyd founding member Roger Waters bought an island together in the Bahamas. Bonds Cay is roughly 550 acres and is part of the Barrey Islands in the Caribbean. They reportedly spent around $16 million for this private island. It has 5 beaches, multiple waterfalls, 3 bays, and a number of lagoons throughout. The island is surrounded by turquoise water that's filled with reefs and fish, making it perfect for snorkeling and fishing. They wanted to turn the island into a carbon-neutral luxury paradise, specifically designed to appeal to rich musicians and artists. Another part of the island would have been turned into an artist's retreat. This was to include studio space, art galleries, and even programs where artists would have taken semester-long sabbaticals. However, after buying Bonds Cay, Shakira was sued by her ex-boyfriend Antonio de la Rua for $100 million. The lawsuit was dismissed in 2013, but as of 2021, Bonds Cay is up for sale. Shakira and Waters seem to have never begun their development of the island. If they did, they haven't commented on it publicly since they bought it. Number 4. Mango Island. Mel Gibson bought Mango in 2005 at a cost of $15 million from Japanese company Tokyu Corporation. It's a volcanic island that's part of Fiji's Northern Lau group of islands. And this island has plenty of land, with around 8.5 square miles. It's one of the largest privately owned islands in the South Pacific. However, when he first bought it, there were some debates on whether he actually owned it. Locals claim that the sale wasn't valid because their ancestors were evicted from Mango Island in the 19th century. However, the Fijian government didn't get involved because the island was just like any other property. The transaction was simply like any other land sold in Fiji between a buyer and a seller, and it was approved by the land minister. Gibson didn't have any plans to transform the island into some sort of exclusive eco-resort. Instead, he's become known for his simple farming lifestyle whenever he stays on the island. He runs a cattle farm on the island, and he's also met with local government representatives to discuss setting up other farming and fishing activities. In fact, Gibson has set up an environmentally sustainable, self-sufficient ecosystem on the island with help from a nonprofit called Organic Matters. Everything that's from Mango Island is organic. That's because in 2013, the Ministry of Agriculture in Fiji declared the island as an organic island. In fact, the island also met the strict organic certification standards of Australia and the US. The island had plans to produce 12 different organic certified products for sale, including beef, lamb, prawns, and oysters. However, we weren't able to find any of the products for sale online. Number 3. Goat K. Tim McGraw and Faith Hill first purchased this private 20-acre island in the Bahamas that they call Little Dengis back in 2003. The island was undeveloped and they didn't know what they had gotten themselves into. They built a 15,000 square feet vacation home, but first they had to put in the essentials. They had to have water and electricity put in. Then they had to put in houses for the staff to live in. It took them 9 years to make the island exactly how they wanted it. When they first started, there was just one little rundown shack. They've since added an 8-pavilion home that's connected by thatched roofs. Just think of the amount of time that it takes to get all the material to a remote island. They wanted their vacation home to blend right in with the environment on the island. That's why there's bleached wood and plenty of tropical accents throughout the property. Whenever they're not vacationing on their island, they live in a modest 3,100 square feet home outside of Nashville, Tennessee. But it sits on over 600 acres and has a 12-stall horse stable, a barn, a restored log cabin, and two guest houses. Number 2. Blackadoor K. In 2005, Leonardo DiCaprio purchased Blackadoor Cay, which is located off the coast of Belize. DiCaprio bought this because he wanted to build an eco-conscious luxury resort on the 104-acre island. He's well known for his environmental activism. He bought the island with a partner soon after he set foot on it. According to him, it was like heaven on earth. But at that time, Blackadoor Cay had suffered from overfishing, an eroding coastline, and deforestation of its mangrove trees. Even though he was building a luxury resort on it, his main focus was to do something that would benefit the island. He wanted the island to be groundbreaking in the environmental movement. DiCaprio first visited Belize in 2005 to swim its barrier reef. And according to him, as soon as he got there, he fell in love. To him, Belize is truly unique. Belize has the second largest coral reef system in the world, and it has some of the most biodiverse marine life in the world. Then there are the Mayan temples and the culture itself. And that's why he bought Blackadoor Cay for $1.7 million with his partner. Blackadoor Cay was supposed to have opened its doors in late 2018, but as of early 2021, there's still no word on when the island will be open for reservations. Number 1. Rooster Cay. Most people don't realize that Eddie Murphy actually has his own private island. Murphy purchased Rooster Cay for supposedly around $15 million back in 2007. Rooster Cay has around 15 acres of mostly pristine, untouched land. The island is a short boat ride away from Nassau, the capital of the Bahamas. And Eddie Murphy is no stranger to the Bahamas. He also used to own another island in the area called Pearl Cay. Nobody is quite sure what Murphy has been doing with the island ever since he bought it. However, people in the know say that Rooster Cay is perfect for developing a luxury resort since it's so close to the capital. Here's what's next.